Okay guys, so this is my very first time making a video about food, but I just wanted to give you guys a preview of like very quick things to make. You guys probably don't know this, but I have gastritis, which is basically like inflammation in the stomach. So these are like my famous, like most healthy crab shrimp cakes. They are delicious, and they're very simple to make. So just to let you know, all you will need for this, and you're carb-free too, by the way. Low carb, like very low carb. All you need to make this is some crab meat, a half a cup or a cup of shrimp. Everything that I use, because I have gastritis, I don't eat meat that often. And when I do eat, it has to be like wild caught, like grass fed. I don't eat red meat, so that's just that. But everything I eat is pretty much organic, like really, really healthy. And I eat, most of the time I eat like vegan most of the time. But every once in a while I'll eat this. So you just need crab meat. I have crab meat combo. So this has like white meat and it has the claw meat in it. I have some Old Bay, which is my favorite. I have some organic fresh parsley, a red onion, which this portion size, you probably need like 1/4 of this, not even that much. Some black pepper, some salt. Again, I use like natural stuff, like very like clean stuff. So this is Private Selection pink Himalayan salt. You will need some cheese. You can make it without the cheese. I just never have this cheese. It takes it to the next level. And this is local milk cheese. It's mozzarella. It doesn't have any antibiotics or RBST in it. It's also gluten-free. It's really good. Really good cheese. And then the secret weapon, it is going to be gluten-free coconut flour. You can use almond flour, but almond flour is ridiculously expensive. So I just use coconut flour. And you will need one egg. So I use natural, cage-free, grain-fed, organic eggs. Everything's organic. So let's start. Very simple. So I already deveined, cleaned, and deshelled my shrimp. And then these is already clean. So all you want to do is, I get my cutting board very quick. The husband just came and said, oh my lord, like he is not a fan of like this crazy stuff, so I gotta be quick because he's been trying to watch TV all day. So I just take some parsley and like, honest to God, I'm not like one of those people who like use measuring. I don't measure anything. I just do it for my taste. But this probably is like, I have no idea. I don't know how much it is. Anyway. Parsley. Chop the parsley. Chop your parsley. Right. Some parsley. I'll put that over there. I'll wash my knife because I'm about to use it to cut this onion. Like I said, I don't use a lot of onion. I love onion. You can use light onion. I just like red onions. They're sweet to me. So I use red onions, but you don't have to. Vidalia onions are just as good. Vidalia onions are sweet too, so I just like red onion. So alright, that should be enough. And honestly, I'm not gonna use all of this. It definitely is a waste, but it is what it is. And I wash my knife again. I like red onions because you don't like tear up with them. I don't know. It's a good thing though. Cheese. Might be like two, three tablespoons. I don't know. Again, I chop this up. I don't recommend using like the stuff in the bag, to be honest. You could definitely tell a big difference. I'll be honest. You could absolutely tell a big difference between good cheese and bad cheese. And I tell you, this is slamming. I have a friend. Oh, Lo, you guys know Lo. Yeah, Lo. She don't really like seafood like that. She came over last week, and I was like, whoa, I'm making these crab shrimp cakes. You gonna taste one? She's like, yeah, I guess I will. And ask her. She ate the whole damn crab cake and wanted another one. It's really good. Like I said, I don't chop this up too fine because, again, it's soft. This is like real mozzarella. And now comes the easy part. And this is 8 ounces. This is a cup. So, to be honest though, this don't really go far for me. Oh, crap. Chop up the shrimp. That's important. Ooh. Gotta chop the shrimp up. You could tell I was rushing. They clean. I just gotta take off the tails. That's one of them. And they're wild, so they have like those like stripes on them. That's not dirt or anything. Just. Yeah, Key Restaurant, Pink Key Restaurant. So I don't know if you want to know what kind I'm using, but that's what I'm using. Wild Caught Pink Key West Shrimp. This is my tail. And I don't chop this up so fine, because I do want to taste this in my like. I do want to taste it. I want to taste this in my food, in my crab cake. And I want it to be. This is a really sharp. Is it sharp? Just apply a little pressure. All right. Okay. Perfect. Now that's good. So I add this into there. It's chopped. And you could put this in a food processor. I did not like it. When I did it, it made it like meal or something. So I'm gonna add the parsley, all the cheese. Every bit of cheese. And so as you can see, that's the onions. I don't know. I'm not like tooting my own horn, but I just cook so well, I don't need to measure. I can look at it. And it's to my personal taste. I'm cooking it for me, so. And I've had gastritis for the last 3 months. It's an awful, awful, awful thing to have, to be honest. Sucks. I pretty much can't eat anything at all. This is Old Bay seasoning. You don't have to. So I season mine how I like. You don't have to season yours like this. I think Old Bay should be like put in every freaking seafood dish. Black pepper. I'm a black pepper fanatic. So you might not want to put that much in here. And salt. I hate using this salt, I swear I do. You gotta have your hands gotta be dry. My hands never are dry when I'm cooking. Mm-hmm. Try to wipe my hands up. I can't do it, get it y'all. Get it. Okay. There we go. Some people think this is salty. I don't really necessarily think so, because binding ingredients. I said this is a one egg. Put the egg inside. Stir it up. No egg means you're not gonna form. Unless you use like this other stuff. If you're like, some people are like vegan. This is true. Some people are vegan, but they still eat eggs. So, and vice versa. Some people are not vegan, but they don't eat eggs. Not usually don't. I don't eat dairy. I'm not going to like make a scrambled egg sandwich. I ain't gonna make no grilled cheese. But if it's in food, most of the time I don't care. But again, I have gastritis, so I can't eat that much of anything, so I'm never really affected by stuff. And then you want to put in just enough coconut flour that like kind of coats the top of what you're making, but not too much, because I did that one time and it came out so gross. Just enough to bond through like, to hold it. You want it to be. Okay, so now comes So what I do is I basically form patties, and like I said, depends on, like, you'll see I eat this off for 2 days. I'll eat it for like 2 straight days. I can't, my stomach can't take a lot of meat, so I try to eat like meat like twice a week, sometimes three. I think this week is about 3 times. But I make the patties. The oil is hot. I use coconut oil. Again, I try to make this as healthy as I can so that my stomach can digest it, because I truly cannot eat a lot of things. And I know you guys see me like, well, you're eating something. I lost 30 pounds in 2 months. So I was like bigger than what you see me now. And the camera adds on like 20 pounds or 10 pounds for sure. But that's neither here nor there. So just drop them in here. So this for me, I like big patties. It's going to only make 4 for me. I'm not going to make these like super small. I want them to fill me up. And I usually only eat like once a day. So it's important that I eat stuff that's going to fill me up. Because I legit eat like once a day. I might have like a smoothie. I'll usually eat like a smoothie. Something like super duper healthy in the morning. Chia seed pudding. Which I'll make a video on that too. That's one of my favorites. But yeah, you definitely don't know. But I definitely lost like 37 pounds in 2 months. I've just been that sick. Man, I'm going to need the bottom of the ground. I'll turn the heat up a little bit. It was really high, but I turned it down, so. Thank you.